Hi guys, today we're quickly going to show you how to do a GRV. So you're going to receive stock. So when will a GRV happen is when you've received an invoice from a supplier and you want to tell the system what products you received and at what cost they're coming in. This is a crucial process that needs to happen if you want to be keeping track of your stock. So you need to GRV all the invoices that come in. So what you'll do is you'll say create new GRV. You'll select a supplier by pressing down arrow. If you don't know how to create suppliers, please go and look at the creating a supplier video. So we're going to just select ABI for this one. We're going to say this is invoice 150. Once again, this invoice number will be the invoice number that you received from them, or you can make it any unique reference number that you want to. And then you come to the payment section where you can say either you've already paid it, meaning you paid this either previously from the system or out of the till, or you want to process the payment now because you have paid them already but you haven't told the system that. So then you can go to this pay now, so it will give you the option of processing the payment now, or you can say we're taking this on account or it's consignment stock. So as you sell, it will require you to pay back this product. So we're just going to say on account for now. Then the GRV has two basic modes. It's got a scan mode, which will allow you to scan the actual barcodes of the product and to utilize the full search functionality. So if we select this, it will allow us to use this whole search functionality, and additionally it will allow us to scan. Okay. Or if you deselect scan mode, you can use this bottom functionality, and you can say, for instance, Archer's Cranberry, and it will populate over there. So then we're going to say how many we received of this Archer's Cranberry. So let's say we received 48 of them. Here you can put in the unit cost. Remember, all these is exclusive cost except for the selling, which is inclusive price. You can put in the per unit price that you paid, or you can just put in the line total. So what is the line total? That is the total amount you've paid for all 48 Archers, excluding VAT. So we're going to say, for instance, we paid 560 Rand for them. Okay. So then it will also populate your margin for you and will show you, is your GP actually correct compared to your selling? And you can have a look if your costing looks correct, but it should be. Remember, this is an exclusive price that you put in over here. So once you hit tab, it will add the line at the top and it will show you what is your VAT required on that specific product. Okay, so you'll just continue doing all the products. Next line. So we can just start typing Archer's Peach. We received 48 of that and it cost us again 560 Rand. Once again, just press tab, which is the button 2 down from escape. So it's escape, then it's the colon button, and then you have the tab button. So you hit tab again and it will populate it. So you'll cycle through all the items on your invoice that you have in front of you until you are done. Once you are done, you must ensure that your total exclusive matches the total exclusive on their GRV, that your total VAT matches the VAT on their invoice that they send you, and that your total inclusive matches the inclusive total on the invoice that they send to you. Just one side note, if you're not a VAT vendor, you must just ensure that your total inclusive matches the total inclusive on the invoice. Your exclusive total will be the same as your inclusive total because you're not a VAT vendor. So don't worry about the VAT in that scenario. But if you are a VAT vendor, make sure all three of these match to within a reasonable extent. We normally give a margin of about 1% error. If you found out that you had made a mistake on a line, you just double click it, it will come back here. And you can say, oh no, sorry, wait, this was not 560 Rand, it was 540 Rand. And you hit tab and it will update it. Okay, so once you've done all of those ones, once again, you can also use this delete line. So you just select the line and you can delete it, or you can add a product. Let's say there's a product on the invoice that you don't have on the system. You can just click add missing item and it will take you to this screen, which is the screen you should know by now. If you don't, please watch the stock one and stock two video. Okay, so we can just close it back. So once you've added that item, it will automatically populate on these lists, and you can just go through it again. So we're happy with this. We're saying everything's matching. If we are 100% happy, everything's matching, we can hit done. This will automatically now go and update your stock quantities. It will update your selling prices if you did change the selling price. And it will also process all the other information on the specific GRV. Other option you've got is you can save it for later, or you can choose the other GRV, meaning you want to continue working on another GRV right now. We're just going to hit save work for later. So let's say the next day we want to continue on that GRV, we didn't have time to finish it. We go there, it will be showing up over here, and we can just hit uncompleted GRV. Okay, so once you've selected uncompleted GRV, it will show up with this screen again, and you can just continue adding the additional lines that you want to process on this specific GRV. Once you're happy with everything, you just hit done with GRV, and then it is completed.